So Trashy was one of our mares, and she went into labor 15 days early and very unexpectedly. With all of her foals in the past, she gets white wax and drips milk, but she did not with this one. So she was not in a foaling stall. So this video shows the adventure that she and her foal had when she gave birth to him out in the paddock. And she was out with another mare that was due around the same time as her and our yearling stud colt. She went into labor around 5:30 a.m. and had it in the paddock by herself. Luckily, she didn't appear to have any issues with the delivery. You'll be able to see a rush of fluid here as her water breaks. So she did this laying down, and this is when the labor began. You can start to see the sac coming out. She progressed quite quickly with her labor, which was good for her. She didn't seem to have too many complications. Other side, mares will typically do this. We see it a lot in the stalls, even that they'll get up and reposition and try pushing out from the other side. Sometimes it just helps the shoulders pass through. So she's got some pretty good strong contractions here, and soon the baby is born. In a hurry, gives a couple of good pushes, and out he slides. Luckily, it was a normal presentation. The colt was, you know, positioned correctly as he came out. He starts wiggling around and breaks the sack on his own. Normally, we would step in and do this. Luckily, he was able to break it there after some struggling. This is why we would normally step in and take the sack off their head so that they can breathe. foal, which again is something that we encourage our mares to do by usually giving them a warm mash at this point. So you can see naturally the mare wants to do this. She just exerted a lot of effort and energy giving birth and is probably in a bit of pain. So we will give them their mash usually at this point, and sometimes give them a bit of medication as well to help with the pain, because birthing in all species can be quite painful. have a hard time getting to their feet because they think that the shavings or hay that we put down can hinder the process, but it's just a normal process. Foals are born with slippers on their feet and they are rubbery and soft, so they definitely don't give them the best traction, but they are important to protect the mare's reproductive tract during the pregnancy and the birthing process. So he squirms around on the ground quite a bit. It was damp outside, so it probably did slow the drying process of the slippers. Typically, the shavings and hay help dry them a little bit faster because it pulls the moisture away from the slippers. realizes that there's something new in the paddock and decides that she might want to go over and investigate once he finally gets up to his feet there. He was quick up to his feet and good and strong. This also encourages Trashy to get up on her feet, even though she was trying to pass her placenta there to guard her baby. A maiden mare, and luckily very sweet to the foal, and Trashy didn't mind her being there so much. So they're both kind of interacting with the foal here a little bit. Trashy then decides maybe Emmy's getting a little too close, but they continue to just kind of interact with the foal safely. And Gambit, meanwhile, is still oblivious and down in the shelter, not realizing what's happening. over and check out the baby, and Trashy's not so sure about this. So she's kind of pinning her ears there, warning Emmy to back off. She comes around the foal and tries to encourage Emmy to leave. Now Emmy is top over Trashy, so here you can see she's a little hesitant to step between Emmy and her baby, but she's trying to make it clear that she doesn't want her anywhere near her foal right now. So a little bit of ear pinning from both of them. Trashy's kind of blocking the baby from Emmy to keep her away. Trashy was quite stressed at this point, and this again is why we wouldn't want to foal them out in a field, because they have this interaction with the other horses which could be dangerous to the foals. Sometimes mares will try to steal babies, sometimes they'll try to attack babies, so again it's generally something that we would like to avoid. Here, but seems to be a little oblivious as to what's going on initially. new addition in the paddock and starts to come over, but thankfully it was very respectful when Trashy told him to back off, and he stops and just observes from a distance. licking and grooming of the foal. She unfortunately starts to push him towards the opening in the fence. So this is what we call man gate. So it's made for the people to go in and out of the paddock easily. And she just keeps kind of grooming him towards it. And he works his way eventually into the man gate. Done. She starts to get a little bit worried and panicked. The poor little guy, as he's kind of trying to find something to nurse on, gets himself zapped by the fence a few times and ends up panicking and going through the opening. You can see here he's a little worried. He's not quite sure where to go. You know, his legs don't work quite good yet, but he eventually kind of works himself out through the man gate and scrambles a little bit and runs off. And of course Trashy starts to panic because her baby's now away and she can't get to him. We're not quite sure where he went because our camera didn't cover the view. Unfortunately, Trashy didn't call out to the foal at all. Normally, I would wake up if I hear one of the horses neighing, because that usually means someone is out, but everyone just stood there and watched as he presumably wandered around the yard a little bit, and Trashy had a little bit of a meltdown. View here. We presume he was just kind of wandering around the driveway a little bit, probably in shock from his literal shocking experience, getting zapped by the fence there. come, and Trashy was desperately trying to get to him, but of course there was a fence in the way. I'm sure he got shocked several more times, and Trashy got shocked a few times as well. Down the driveway. He was pretty good on his feet, but he was trying to find another way maybe back to her, so he started wandering down the driveway, and he actually made it pretty far before he turned back around, thankfully. Times. Luckily he's good on his feet, but he was trying to stay close to Mom, but couldn't figure out how to get back to her. from his mom for just over an hour. He eventually made it along the fence line, and we're pretty sure he basically just kind of fell down the little embankment there and fell into the paddock. You'll be able to see the electric fence move here in a moment, where we presume he slid through the fencing and ended up back in the paddock. He was out, you know, long enough. He passed three meconium poops on his own. There he is, getting back in the paddock. So he finally got in just by fluke of nature. Luckily, he didn't injure himself in his wild adventure. He was no worse for the wear. We had him checked over by the vet. Definitely nerve-wracking for both mom and baby to be separated like that. He was certainly trying, and I imagine he was quite hungry from his adventures. But Trashy was standing there nicely with him, and we're assuming he maybe got a little bit of a drink there. corner with their breakfast and was very shocked to see a foal in the paddock next to Trashy, said a few choice words, set down their grain, and then immediately started contacting the girls that were across the road on the other property to let them know that Trashy dropped her baby in the field. To let him know that we had a foal born and we weren't quite sure of the timelines. Contacting, I go in and get a stall prepped for them so that she's got a space that we can bring her in and put her. Luckily, we had an empty stall in the barn. Trashy haltered, and Anna gets her hands on the baby so that we can move them safely out of the paddock and into the stall that we prepped for them. Dakota's manning the gate to make the process a little bit smoother. Okay, even though this was quite the great adventure for Trashy's colt, and Trashy was quite stressed about it. She was instantly relieved when we got her in the stall and she was able to relax right away. We made sure the colt was nursing and that all of his timelines were passed and everyone was good to go.